topic is polygons, that is mathematics form 1. So what is polygon? Polygon are flat shapes. In other words, these are two-dimensional figures. A two-dimensional figure is the one that we are referring to the polygon. Now, whenever we are talking about polygon, you know polygon means many. And therefore, these are shapes that have three sides or more than three sides. So, note this, that under whenever you are talking of polygons, we have regular, polygons and irregular polygons. So I want us to discuss more about regular polygons. So if we start with the first example, we have a triangle. The first example of a polygon is a triangle. So the name of a triangle is a triangle, and you know how a triangle is drawn. It has three vertices. If it is one, it is known as a vertex. So how many sides are there in this polygon? So we have 1, 2, 3. So we have three sides. How many angles? 1, 2, 3. We have three angles. If you look at that example, you will find out that the number of sides is the same as number of angles. So the second one, after triangle with three sides, the one with four sides, they are known as quadrilaterals because they are many. So examples of quadrilaterals we have square. These are examples. Examples of quadrilaterals. So we have square, we have rectangle, we have the parallelogram. We have rhombus, then we have trapezium. When they are many, they are known as trapezium. Trapezium singular, plural trapezium. So if you look at the first four letters, quad means four. That's why it's a four-sided figure. If we take an example of a rectangle, you find that it has four sides, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it has four sides and four angles, 1, 2, 3, 4, and four angles. Then from there, we have the third one, the one with three sides, we have said triangle, four sides, quadrilateral, five sides is known as pentagon. And we have said it has four sides, it has five angles. The other one is hexagon. Hexagon with three sides and six sides and six angles. That one is heptagon. Seven sides, seven angles. The other one is octagon. Eight sides, eight angles. And please don't confuse these, because some of you, when you take what comes to your mind is the word October, which is the 10th month, which is wrong. In our case here, yes, October is the 10th month, but octagon is a shape with eight sides. Then the one with nine sides is known as nonagon. And you have said it has nine angles. Then lastly is decagon, which has 10 sides and 10 angles. Now, how do we get the sum of the interior angles? Basically, in primary school, you learned that interior angles, especially the triangle, the sum of in the triangle, add up to 180 degrees. So that one is very simple. If it is quadrilateral, how do you get 360 degrees? So if you take an example of a rectangle, make sure when you are splitting, you split in a way that the lines that you are going to draw at the middle are not intersecting. So you cannot draw another line there to form triangles. So in other words, we want to form triangles in the figure in question. So that's the only way you can divide or you can split your quadratic. Because when you split the other way, you find that the lines are intersecting, which is wrong. So the only way to split is either this direction, this diagonal, or the other one. And if you look at our quadrilateral, which is a rectangle, it has two triangles. And you know that one triangle, some of interior angles adapt to 180, and the other one adapt to 180 degrees. That's why quadrilaterals, some of interior angles adapt to 360 degrees. Then, this one, which is pentagon, if you want to know the sum of interior angles, for example, if we have an example of a pentagon here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's an example of a pentagon. You have seen it has 5 sides and 5 angles. Try to split in a way that you are going to get triangles, but don't make sure that the lines that you are using to split are not intersecting, like our example here. So you will find that it has 1, 2, 3 triangles. Each triangle adapts 180 degrees, 180 degrees, 180 degrees. So it is 180 degrees times 3, which is 0. This is 4, carry 2. This is 3 plus 2, 5 degrees. So a pentagon adapts to 540 degrees. So if you look at these two examples, there is something that should guide you. That if you want to know the sum of interior, sum of interior angles, then it will be the sum of the total number of degrees in one triangle, you multiply by the number of triangles, you multiply by the number of triangles. And if you look keenly, we can get, there is a way of getting number of triangles. How do we get number of triangles? Look at this one. A quadrilateral has two. So if you look at the side, it has 1, 2, 3, 4. It has 4 sides. And from these 4 sides, how do we get these two triangles? If you subtract 2, you get the number of triangles. Look at this one. The number of sides are 5 sides. If you subtract 2, you see that you get 3 triangles and you have 1, 2, 3. So this is a concept that you should know. To get the number of triangles is the number of sides. To get the number of triangles is number of sides minus 2. Number of sides minus 2. So once you know that, it becomes very simple for you to get the rest. So we have said sum of interior angles is equal to 180 times the number of triangles. And we have said this number of triangles is represented by number of sides minus 2. So we can conclude and say sum of interior angles in a polygon will be 180 degrees minus the number, sorry, times the number of sides. And the number of sides is represented by n. N is the number of sides minus 2. So we can come up with the formula n, 180 bracket n minus 2. So if you want to get even the hexagon, you just say 180 times, because it is hexagon, it is 6. So in bracket, 6 minus 2. So it will be 180 times 4. So this is 180 times 4. This is 0. This is 32. So it is 2 carry 3 and 7 degrees. So the total number of degrees in a hexagon is 720 degrees. Heptagon, we have said use the same formula. 180 in bracket n minus 2. So this is 180 pentagon, it has seven sides, so it will be 7 minus 2, so this is 180. We are multiplying by 5, multiplying by 5 here, 0, 0 carried 4, 9, so we get 900 degrees. Octagon, the same way, so you can try to work out using this formula and finish, know the number of the sum of angles in an octagon, nonagon, and decagon. Hope you have enjoyed.